Prek Dam, disembarkation. Some of you will go on to other locations in Cambodia, while others will move on to other countries and continents. For a little time, you were all traveling together aboard the RV Discovery, learning about Vietnam, Cambodia, and the Mekong River's riches. We hope that you will treasure your memories and photos of the wonderful adventures you shared here for a very long time after you have left.
Your show today. Because to uncontrollable navigational conditions, the cruise itinerary is subject to vary. Early risers can find coffee, tea, and pastries in the layback lounge starting at 6 a.m. Please place your bags outside of your stateroom door between 7 o'clock and 7:30 a.m. Breakfast is available at the hall restaurant from 7 to 9 a.m. The motor coaches will be laden with luggage. Time to check out of your staterooms is 8:30 a.m. Please give your key cards back to the front desk. Please keep your water bottle holders, earpieces, and audio equipment in your stateroom. Disembarkation begins at 9 a.m. in the layback lounge. After disembarking, bid the Discovery a fond farewell. We will board buses to travel to Siem Reap, approximately 5.5 hours.
Arrive at the Sofitel Angkor Hotel at 2:30 p.m. Before embarkation, please double-check that you have all of your belongings, and if possible, leave the safe open. We wish you a safe onward journey. Background information. Siem Reap, Cambodia. The name Siem Reap, which translates to Defeat of Siam, relates to a bloodbath that occurred centuries ago and was memorialized in stone in the renowned bas relief carvings of the monuments. By supporting an expedition to the Bayonne in 1901, the École Française d'Extrême Orient, EFEO, launched a long partnership with Angkor. After being taken over by Thailand, Cambodia regained possession of Angkor in 1907, and the EFEO was given charge of cleaning up and repairing the entire complex. The first visitors to Angkor arrived that year, 200 of them in just 3 months, which was a record. After being rescued from the jungle, Angkor was now settling into the modern era.
When the first French explorers rediscover Angkor in the 19th century, Siem Reap was merely a village. The first wave of tourists arrived in Siem Reap in 1907, following the return of Angkor to Cambodia or French sovereignty. The Grand Hotel d'Angkor first opened its doors in 1929, and until the late 1960s, the temples of Angkor continued to be one of Asia's top tourist destinations, drawing celebrities like Charlie Chaplin and Jacqueline Kennedy. The communist Khmer Rouge forcefully drove the inhabitants of Siem Reap and the rest of Cambodia's cities and towns into the countryside in 1975.
The cruelty of the Khmer Rouge regime has left its mark on Siem Reap's history, as well as the recollections of its residents, much like it has on the rest of the nation. However, after Pol Pot's passing in 1998, there has been a reviving the tourism sector, which has been a crucial step in the rebuilding process. Currently, Siem Reap is without a doubt Cambodia's city with the highest population growth, acting as a small, quaint entryway to the famed Angkor monuments. Currently a popular tourist destination, Siem Reap is a bustling city with up-to-date hotels and structures. Despite outside influences, Siem Reap and its inhabitants have maintained a good deal of the town's reputation, culture, and traditions.
Due to the tourism boom, businesses with a focus on tourism have prospered. There are numerous five-star hotels, upscale resorts, and numerous inexpensive guesthouses among the many hotels available. Food from many different cuisines, including Italian, Indian, French, German, Russian, Thai, Korean, Japanese, and Burmese, is available at a variety of restaurants. Around the Sar Chaz region, there are several shopping options, and there are a lot of pubs and clubs with a Western aesthetic.
The majority of visitors to Cambodia arrive at Siem Reap Angkor International Airport in Siem Reap. The majority of visitors arrive in Siem Reap to see Angkor Wat, Angkor Thom, located approximately 4 miles north of the city, and other Angkor archaeological sites. These are still the main draws, but there are also a ton of additional activities to take part in, such as a dinner with an Apsara dance performance, a trip to fishing towns and bird sanctuaries, a stop at a craft shop or a farm that produces silk, or a bicycle tour of the nearby rice terraces. The Gecko Environment Center, a floating environmental center on the Tummel Sap Lake, is also situated in the Siem Reap province.
The Gecko Environment Center seeks to increase both local residents and Great Lake visitors' knowledge of environmental issues. The Tummel Sap Biosphere Reserve includes the province of Siem Reap. Fishermen and rice farmers make up the majority of Siem Reap's population. The port town is laid back and has a bustling fish trade. The neighborhood residents can be seen strolling up and down the recently erected river promenade in the early evening and on weekends.
Important reminders. Please thoroughly check your staterooms, paying special attention to the areas under the bed, in the drawers, and in the safe. Please remember to pick up your passport before embarking, and we kindly ask that you vacate your stateroom by 8:30 a.m. Please leave the safe open and return stateroom cards to the reception desk upon checkout. Many thanks. Please turn in all questionnaires to the questionnaires box at reception while packing, and have all necessary paperwork, such as passports and prescriptions, close to hand.